Hey everybody, Bradley Pierce with CFO Entertainment. Thanks for tuning in. I'm here with my good friend Raccoon Martin and his 1985 DeLorean time machine. So tell us a little bit about why this time machine.
Well, it's been a dream of mine since I was a little kid. I was 9 years old when I first saw the film in theaters in July of 1985. And it was something that I wanted to do my entire life. I never thought it could actually happen. But lo and behold, the future is what you make of it, kids.
So Raccoon, did you make any of these parts?
Yes, some of them were actually fabricated from the Hero A car that was featured in the film Back to the Future. So as you can see, it is one of the best replicas out there.
Was there any particular part of the process of the reproduction that was difficult or especially time consuming?
The most difficult part of the process was actually financing the project. It was a real difficult time to secure the auto loan and then also secure the financing for the actual conversion itself. That was the most difficult part. And then getting the car up to speed. It was in pretty decent shape when I bought the car, but the previous owner did not take care of it. So there were some cosmetic adjustments made and also some internal mechanical repairs that needed to be taken care of.
About how long did it take you to get from stock DeLorean to the replica we got?
Brad, that's a great question. I bought the stock DeLorean in March of 2012 from the DeLorean Motor Company in Garden Grove, California. And it was about a 3-year process to convert the car into a time machine. It's been an absolute joy, a labor of love for sure.
Less about the car, more about you. If you could time travel to any place in time, where, when, and why?
I would love to travel back to 1964. To see the Beatles play on the Ed Sullivan Show in New York City on February 9th, 1964. It's hard to pick just one date, but I'm a huge Beatles fan. They're my favorite. They also influenced my musical compositions and my rock and roll band, which is also called Raccoon. We play locally here in Los Angeles.
So you told me that you chose the plutonium reactor as opposed to the Mr. Fusion. What?
I prefer the look. It's much more interesting to look at. The Mr. Fusion is fun. Most fans love the Mr. Fusion, but I'm more of a purist. I like Back to the Future Part 1. It's my favorite. Part 2 and Part 3 are great and they're fun. But I prefer the original Jennifer, Crispin Glover, Michael J. Fox, and of course he's in all three. But I'm a purist. So I love the aesthetic look of the plutonium chamber. Mr. Fusion kind of covers up all this beautiful artwork here.
I'm sure when you're driving around in this thing, even when you pulled in here to the parking lot today, you got swarmed with people that wanted pictures. Do you have any especially cool stories of somebody you've met or something that's happened to you while you were driving the time machine?
Yeah, it's I like to call it a mobile field of dreams. I know it sounds a little bit cheesy and cliche, but it really is. It's if you build it, they will come, and it makes people happy. It makes me happy, and it makes most people who are familiar with the film franchise happy. I've had some amazing experiences. I had the luxury and opportunity to meet Miss Leah Thompson. The car was featured on Dancing with the Stars in September of 2014. I also met Doc Brown, Mr. Christopher Lloyd himself, that same year. And it's an interesting story because I put up one of my flyers at M Cafe, as a plug for you, on Melrose and La Brea. And I got a phone call about 2 months later from this woman, and she said, "Hey, give me a call, I'm interested in your car." I said, "Great." So I gave her a call back, and she's like, "Well, do you know Bob Gale?" I said, "No, I don't know Bob Gale personally. Bob Gale happens to be the George Lucas of the Back to the Future franchise. He's the producer, writer, and creator, along with Robert Zemeckis." I said, "No, I don't know Bob Gale, but I have a few friends who know him very well." And she's like, "Well, I'm Christopher Lloyd's girlfriend." I said, "Really?" I was surprised that it was her, and she's like, "We're doing a charity function up in Santa Barbara with Christopher Lloyd and Bob Gale, and we would love to have your car there as part of the event and part of the charity auction for the Police Foundation in Santa Barbara." So that was how that came about. So it's been a real treat having the car, meeting some awesome people.
Back to the Future was obviously a huge influence on your life, enough that you've made this. Tell us a little bit about how that got started and how you grew up.
Absolutely. The theme, again, from Doc Brown saying, if you put your mind to it, you can accomplish anything. That's still a theme that I live by to this very day. Back in the 80s, when a brand new film would come out on VHS, it was very expensive. This actually retailed for $79.95 when it came out. And at the time it was super scotch hi-fi. So, of course I had to buy it, but I couldn't buy it right away because I was 9 years old. I didn't have the money. But my dad bought it for me for my 11th birthday in 1986. Because it didn't come out on video until the following year. And because I was such a big fan and there was no iPods back in the day, what I would do is I recorded the movie on audio cassette so I could listen to it while I was riding around in my BMX with mag wheels on my Walkman. So I made a little cassette. It has four sides to it, just like an old record. There's part one, part two, and I cut out little pictures from the movie from newspaper clippings and then would add them in here. So what I would ride around on my BMX bike or go on vacation with my family, sit in the back seat. I couldn't watch my iPod, which is such a luxury nowadays. I would just listen to the movie, and I had seen it so many times I could imagine every scene in my head.
These time circuits are set for specific dates. Can you change?
You can. Not on my car yet. That's a big upgrade.
Okay.
Quite an expensive upgrade, but down the road, that's something that I would like to do. I did pick these particular dates because they have significance from the movie. The destination time is the time that they're going to at the end of part one, and they enter in part two. The present time is the actual date and time of the first time travel with Einstein, the dog, in part one. And then this is from part one as well, 1955. This is the time and the date that the lightning hit the clock tower. 10:04 p.m. on Saturday, November 12th, 1955.
There it is. Very cool.
Yeah.
What other projects are you involved in? I mean, obviously you're really passionate about Back to the Future and the DeLorean, but you've got to have other hobbies, other things you're interested in. What else you have going on?
I do. Well, I have my rock and roll band, which is Raccoon, R-A-K-O-O-N. The website is raccoonrollmusic.com. We are a local L.A. based rock and roll band. Influences are 1968 Beatles, Led Zeppelin, T-Rex, Motley Crue. That is my hardcore passion, and that is actually a stem from Marty McFly playing Johnny B. Goode at the end of Back to the Future. That was when I got my first guitar in 1986 and wanted to pursue a career in acting. I'm also in the Screen Actors Guild, like yourself. I've been featured in several national commercials, including the Taco Bell campaign in the year 2000 with the little Chihuahua. One of my claims to fame was I was featured in a scene with Steve Carell on season 2 of The Office, the Christmas party episode. I sell Steve 15 bottles of vodka for the Christmas party back at The Office. So I have that. I also have a company that was born from my love for Halloween Horror Nights, working Halloween Horror Nights with you in 2013. Me and my good brother Joey Mustache, we decided to form our own company called Zombies for Hire. That's a number 4 hire. And we offer that type of Halloween scare actor service at any event, big or small. We do Scare LA, Monsterpalooza, and we have a great time with that.
Last, if somebody wanted more information on your DeLorean or on how to hire you to come to an event or something like that, get in touch with you for something, how would they do that?
What you would do is contact me at raccoontothefuture.com, which is featured here, the logo. That is the same handle for the Instagram account, Facebook account, and you can also look for the hashtag DMC1985, which is my license plate, and you can contact me there. It's not outrageously expensive. You can, we can work with your budget.